Hello, this is Heather Dewey Pettit, and I just wanted to do a little video and take a sip of coffee. So I just wanted to do a little vlog-ish video about, excuse me, just basically to say hi I want to say sorry. I haven't made any videos lately. I've been really busy. I've been busy with lots of things. First, I had that large editing job, and so that is done. And so I've been doing some other things. And sorry, I'm messing with my hair again. Anyway. Let's see. So I might do some kind of creative video tomorrow. I don't know. I'll have to see, because actually tomorrow we're helping my mother move tomorrow. So we're gonna be pretty busy. But if there is some downtime. Besides, I'm gonna have to keep my son pretty busy anyway. There's some things he can help us, but anyway, we'll have to see. We'll have to see how that goes. I started filming a video yesterday, something I'm working on my book. So basically working with this book called Tarot for Writers. I had filmed it yesterday for Writer Wednesday, but I'm really gonna learn to start filming earlier. And I haven't done any editing with that. What was I gonna say? This book, let me grab it. Again, it's called Tarot for Writers by Corinne Kenner. In it, she talks about, among other things, plot, and this using tarot cards are a great way to plot out your story, your novel, or whatever, or anything. But within tarot, tarot readers use their cards to create what they call spreads, which is just a visual storytelling medium. The tarot cards are that, rather. What she's done here is she's taken some spreads. And one of them is called the Celtic Cross. And so she's got another version of the Celtic Cross, and she's called it the Writer's Celtic Cross. And using that spread for writing projects. She used that, drew some cards, and made this. And as you can see, it's got all the stuff on it. The setting, protagonist, antagonist, and all that stuff, as well as using a standard plot points. There's another spread that she has in here And this one I'm definitely excited about because it's based on the hero's journey. Literary model that Joseph Campbell outlined in Hero with a Thousand Faces. So she's got it's really interesting how the what in tarot it's called what tarot readers call the Fool's Journey, and that's been around for like 100 years. So and how that parallels the hero's journey literary model. And so it's really fascinating how writers have used the same basic storyline for eons, literally. I just find that fascinating. Anyway, okay, where was I? So anyway, she's got a spread, the hero's journey spread. I have done a little bit of that in the past, so I want to finish that. I really want to get this my outline, my bare bones outline finished, because it's not really, even though I have been working on it. So I kind of gone back to wanting to use visual plots, because I think it's just going to help keep me organized and stuff. So I think it's just going to help me. And then so bah, sorry, sorry about the ums. So I don't know if I'm going to finish. I don't know if I'm gonna upload anything of the stuff that I filmed yesterday, but I at least wanted to let you guys know that I've been working on that, and I can do basically I can do a video, and I can just try again. I can just try again and see what I can do about see what I can do about getting a video made on that book and on those two spreads and what I did with those two spreads. So and another thing I did want to mention before I forget is that I have to remember to look at my notes. I'm going to be doing a tag video called The Voices of Young Adult, YA, whatever. So I'll be doing that tag video in response to Kim S. Good. She is a YouTuber that I've been following, and she was my, I think she was my first subscriber. I have five, which is, it's a beginning. It's a beginning. I've only really done, a few videos really or so. Anyway, I really need to make this short because I've got some stuff I gotta do and some writing before I have to meet my son at the bus stop. He's in summer school. Anyway, let's see, what was I gonna say? Basically, hopefully really soon I'll have more time to write after helping my mother move, and then also really after summer is over I'll have more time because when my son's home I have to pay attention to him and we have to hang out, and that's just how it goes. That's just how it goes in my family. Sometimes I can do things, other things around him, but usually I really have to, I need to, he takes up, well, what I'm trying to say is, he just needs a lot of my attention. But anyway, what I really wanted to say was, you know, I'll be doing more videos after the school, the regular school year starts. So, because I'll have a little bit more time. Anyway, one other thing I wanted to mention, super quick. I hope it'll take this long video. is that but I will be doing as many more creative, artsy type of videos pretty soon here, artsy or craftsy or whatever you want to say. I would like to be doing. Would like to still be doing those on at least posting them on Fridays, so I guess I'm calling them my artsy fartsy videos. Anyway, so I wanted to mention something that I have made recently is some bracelets. I like to crochet. Well, I'm a beginner crocheter. Let me just say that right now. The chaining was really helping me learn how to do it. So I said, God, there's got to be something I can do with all this chaining that I've been doing. And I started making a few things just out of chaining. And then I researched it, and apparently a lot of people are making things made of crochet chaining. So I wasn't the first one to get that idea, but oh well. So I make some things, including some bracelets. I had these all styled yesterday, but anyway. I've been making it. Oh shoot! I'm sorry. I've been making and selling. These bracelets off and on for a while. Why does that look like that? Anyway, I sell them for $5 if they're plain, or for $6 if they have a charm. If they have one charm, I add $1. If they have two charms, I add $2. So that seems to make a lot of sense. And I do, I did sell some, this past spring at a horse event that I went to. It was the Denimy ones that sold there. As well as, I believe I sold one of these, I believe. And, so anyway, those are some of the, things I make. So if anybody wants to see a process video on how I make my crochet chain bracelets, please let me know in the comments. And I hope you like this video. I hope it's not too rambly. Also please subscribe if you haven't, and because I would love to build my audience. Thanks so much for watching, and have a great day. Bye.